Hi, my name is Lisa and I am an occupational therapist, specialized in Padovan therapy, master in autism spectrum disorder. And today I would like to share with you a small part of my sessions, of my Padovan therapy session. The reason why I would like to share this particular video is because I would like to make a little bit of an emphasis on the importance of dragging phase. And sometimes as a therapist, we forget actually what is dragging phase and why it's so important. Basically what I'm doing is I'm stimulating the lower part of the body of the child, and by pushing and pressing her knees and her ankles, and trying to stimulate her to push forward. Sometimes I place different materials or different toys in front of the child, so like that, to stimulate even the interest and the look and eye contact between the child, the movement and the toys, and in order to stimulate this pushing forward. Now dragging phase in our milestones, it's not always there. I have many kids that comes and they didn't have, for example, they didn't pass through rolling phase, or they didn't have dragging phase, and it's okay. It's not meaning that there is a consequence because of that, but in my practice and in my experience, I find it very relative, the fact that it's interesting to observe that in many occasions, child who didn't crawl or who didn't pass through dragging phase, or crawling or dragging or both, it happens, has difficulties with balancing, difficulties with coordination, and difficulties in general, with spatial awareness, tolerating different movements, accepting swings, or accepting different equipment that moves like trampoline or other swing that you can see here, or even simply a peanut ball or a therapy ball. So it is interesting to observe all of this, and this is why I would like to enhance and push a little bit all the parents and therapists to continue working and to not to forget to stimulate the dragging phase. It's a very simple exercise and it's really useful. As you know, our nerve system, it's built up through milestones. It's what make us be able to talk, walk, think, go to job, do our writing, our reading, be able to move in the space surrounding us, be able to adjust our body, our weight, our body awareness. Okay, so what basically during my sessions, most of the time, what I focus a lot, it's in rolling and dragging. Obviously, if the child is not prepared, and this is super important to have sort of like a note, if the child is not ready and is not prepared to do dragging, what we are going to do is we are going to focus only, my suggestion, it's only in rolling and crawling. And step by step, prepare the child, build up that system in order to say, okay, maybe now you are ready to introduce the dragging position. This is super important to consult with your physiotherapist, occupational therapist, Padovan therapist, early intervention therapist. Important to understand if your child is in the phase to work on crawling, rolling, or dragging. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like that you will have always notification of my videos, and press the like button. I wish you good luck in your practice and stay safe.